I'm Gretchen Fleeta from the Philippines. Hi, J-Lo, Seemlin Sterling. Good
Hello.
to see you guys.
Hey, Gretchen.
Hello.
Okay, so in this day and age when technology keeps on advancing every second and every minute, and there's just so much more to be discovered, what message does this film want to convey about artificial intelligence, and what are your personal thoughts on AI?
Be careful.
Proceed with caution.
There you go.
Be respectful.
Yeah, there's something of tremendous benefit to society and could also be a tremendous danger. And ultimately, I think it's probably going to wind up being both. But maybe we can mitigate the bad part and maximize the good part.
Right.
Yeah.
And I think the movie does a good job of kind of showing both sides of how it can be really, really helpful and how it can be super destructive.
Yeah. I think Harlan is the perfect example of you should never let AI lead. You know, AI should always be used to support and enhance our lives, but we should never be using AI to make decisions, because AI there's some things that you can never quantify in code, you know, the human experience, empathy for one another. And when you say, oh, it's better if we fire these people, or it's better if we do this or do that, and you don't factor in the human cost associated with it, I think that just leads us down a very, very dangerous road.
J-Lo, you're one of the co-producers of this film. What was the inspiration and how you conceptualized the story? And your character, Atlas, she's smart, she's driven, and she's such a fighter, such an empowering example that we as women can actually change the world.
Yeah, or save it.
Boom.
Yeah,
boom.
Or save it.
Save it.
I think, you know, when I read the script in an early iteration, but always the core of the movie was there, which was this idea about trust and trusting people and letting someone in. And I think Atlas and Smith's relationship really shows that in a beautiful kind of interesting and new way of how you let somebody in, and this AI kind of chipping away at her hard shell the whole entire time. And there's something about the fact that he is an AI that makes it, you know, makes him less emotional. I think if she was, you know, if it was me and Sterling's character, let's say, you know, we'd be fighting and he'd have his side and my side, and he'd be like rolling his eyes at me because I'm so difficult and all that kind of stuff. Yeah. But this AI was able to kind of like just stay very steady with her and keep telling her, like, this is who I am. I'm here for you. I'm not leaving you. I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to do all this and mean it. And at the end of the story, really give up his life for her. And I think for me, even in the developing it and producing it and all that, to me, that part of the story was the thing that was the most important to get through. The setting it in the world of AI and in the future, you know, kind of just made it great for sci-fi and action and thriller.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? In a way. And put it in a different kind of world.
But you're also saying relationship-wise, if you had a man like Smith, everything would be fine.
Oh my God, yes.
That's true.
They didn't take anything you did personally, right? If they just listened to you and just were the steady kind of like, I'm here, I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah.
I'm going to be here. I understand that this is hard for you.
Right.
Just let me in.
Note to
let
self.
Me in. Yeah.
Be you like know Smith. What
I mean? Okay. Be like Smith.
Gotcha.
I want to ask you, J-Lo, can you somehow see yourself in Atlas in real life, given that, you know, you've experienced so much in your life and in your career?
I think it's different for me. Like, I feel like Atlas and I are the same and very, very different. I feel like I'm more emotionally available as a person, and she really isn't. Mm-hmm. Like, there is something that happened in her childhood that has just shut her down, and she can't let anybody in. She becomes solely kind of singularly obsessed with kind of what she has to do to right what has happened in her childhood. But then at the same time, I think in my professional life, and because I've been in the public eye for a long time, I understand the idea of, you know, kind of putting up a barrier with people sometimes, which I'm not completely proud of, but has become my life in a way. Mm-hmm. You know, it's hard to trust people and know what they want and what their agenda is, or it's not just somebody coming up to you. They're coming up to you with all these ideas in their head about you. They think they know you. They think they understand you, you know, and they want a specific thing from you. And you're not really sure if their intentions are always good.
Yeah.
You know, so in a way, I understand the trust part, trusting and the not trusting.
In some ways, you can never be enough, too. You can never live up to somebody's idea of who you are. And it's like all you can ever, you know, maybe sounding too defeatist, but sometimes it's like, yeah, no matter what you do, it's like, is it ever enough? I don't know.
Hmm.
I don't know.
That's right. What about you, Sterling?
I think that you have to, when you get to a certain place, and I think these guys are probably even much further beyond than where I am, where people want things from you, and you don't know if they're just attracted to your celebrity and the fact that they see you on screens, et cetera, and that's the reason, they just want to be close to you, and that sort of gets them something by proxy, or if they care about you as a human being, right? I think my trust is first and foremost in God, truth, like, I mean, unabashedly so. And so I believe that the people that the universe, God, nature puts in my path are there for a reason. And I trust God first and foremost.
Sometimes they're there for a lesson, though.
Sometimes.
They're about to be, you know.
I hear you.
Brutal to you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'll be like, I'll
take
the lesson.
You got to trust that.
Yeah.
Mm. Well, J-Lo, Stephen Sterling, I just like to say thank you so much. I'm out of time, but congratulations on Atlas and thank you and your fans here in the Philippines are so excited to see it. Thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Take care, Gretchen.
Bye.
Good morning, Atlas. Time to wake up.
I'm awake.
Agent Atlas Shepard has spent years of her life hunting the artificial intelligence known as Harlan. Originally engineered to advance humanity, instead nearly ended it.
If you really want to try to capture Harlan, you need me on that mission.
Mayday, we are under attack.
What do I do?
Strap it!
Oh my God.
Okay, this is out of control.
This planet is unstable and inhospitable.
Atlas, my name is Smith.
Is that really necessary? You're a computer program.
I'm driving through L.A. out of Roscoe.
No, I'm not.
No? What are you then?
I am a computer program named Smith.
No one likes a smart-ass Smith. We don't have much time. Harlan's planning an attack.
Atlas, my primary protocol is to keep you alive.
Same! I don't need your help. I don't trust any AI. Smith?
Okay, this is out of control.
Atlas, this won't work if you don't trust me.
Okay. Let's do this.
Keep everything I know about it. Know about it.
This is what it feels like to be you.
This is what it feels like to be us.
It's beautiful.
Don't worry. We are simply the better versions of you.
If we don't stop Harlan, all life on Earth is doomed.
You everything I know about it.
Shit.
You're in my head and the only thing you learn how to do is curse?
I'm an adaptive learner.
Okay. Let's go, bitch.
Okay, this is out of control. Okay, this is out of control.